should be on bases and eating up. Keep it on the P and eat the nook.
A lot of people know me by the name Alejo Martin Oludebilade. Some people know me as YC. Omo Alaji number one. I am a rap musician from Lagos, Nigeria. I'm welcoming you to the brand new season of My Music and I on Sound City. Don't go anywhere. Baby, can be finer, wearing everything designer. I'm signed to the record label Tiny Entertainment. I've been signed to them since 2012 to this point. I just released my first body of work, my EP, titled The First Wave, and that came out on the 7th of April, 2017. Let the haters hate, my whole team living great. So the EP has 8 songs on it. It was initially supposed to be released last year, but you know, working on a lot of things, trying to make it better, mixing and mastering, and it eventually came out on the 7th of April. Cause I'm about to dance my life away today. You know, there's 8 songs, there's 6 of the songs that has features on them, and you know, one of the biggest songs from the EP is, you know, currently one of the biggest songs in the country right now, Juice. It features Malik Berry and it was produced by Ade. So working on Juice for me is, you know, just like every other project I work on, I like to make every release as different from the previous one. And, you know, every session has to be different, just so, you know, there's a lot of spontaneity involved in the process. And then I pull up in your driveway. You know, there's Need to Know, which features Shay Shay, also produced by Ade. And I think, low-key, that's one of my favorite songs on the EP, because it's not something you find YC doing regularly. I just wanted, on this project, I wanted to show people a different side to the kind of music I make, the kind of music I enjoy listening to that they weren't used to. I mean, Shay Shay is someone I've worked with in the past, and as soon as I hit her up to be on the record, she was down and she came through and she did her thing. You know, there's Link Up, which features Ricardo Banks as well. That was previously released before the EP itself came out. And so I hit up Ricardo because around the time he released his album, I was listening to it and I liked what he did on it. So I sent him the beat. And in 2 days, he's recorded and he sent back his chorus and everything. And that's how Link Up came about. You know, we sip the Bubbly, which features Fouls. It was produced by BBK, Beast by Karma, who is also my elder brother. Pause, but you know they rush. The one we they get, be straight from the source. I be real G, I know they for the wash. If I check. I remember I was at Fouls' place and I played the song. And Fouls also, he liked it and he was like, yo, like he wants to be on the song. So we made that happen as well. Kill Nobody. It features a singer from the US. His name is Calibri. The producer is 2-7. He's from the UK. So the story behind this is my first time in the UK, 2016. I visited 2-7's, you know, studio and he played the song and the chorus was there already. But he was like, you know, there are a lot of people that have listened to the beat. They didn't know what to do with the beat. A lot of people, like, they can't voice on this song. You know, I was like, yo, this is, because it sounded like what we do in Nigeria, like, every day. So I was like, yo, this is something that I could do easily. And we called Calibri on FaceTime because he was in the US. Up to this point, I still haven't met Calibri. So, I mean, the whole session was going on. He was on FaceTime. He was providing input and everything. And, you know, that's how that song came about. Oh, nah, nah. Don't Need Bae is another favorite of mine off the song. You know, it's produced by Malik Berry and we recorded that song in 2000. I think that's the first song I worked with Malik Berry on in 2016. So yeah, so I mean, that's just, you know, talking about like a few songs off the EP. So as regards, you know, the impact I think my music has made in the past 2-3 years, I think, you know, my music has been able to cross over different tribes, different states and everything. But I mean, there's still places in Nigeria and outside Nigeria that I think I haven't visited, that, you know, I haven't performed in, I haven't met the fans I have out there, and I would really love to, like, you know, in the West. I think I've been to Ilorin only once. And I know I have a lot of, you know, followership out there. There's a lot of people that listen to my music out there. Shogo, I've been to Oshogo only once. Some parts in the north, I go to Abuja a lot, but still I haven't been to places like Kano, Kaduna, and I mean in the south as well, you know, Delta State, which is where my mom is even from. So, I mean, these are places that I would really love to visit and, you know, meet my fans out there, Ghana, Cameroon. I think if I start calling, you know, countries that I haven't been to, it's gonna take a lot. Haven't been to Canada yet. I haven't had any show in the US, any proper show in the US. So this year, definitely, these are places that we look at exploring and making the most of. Before the year runs out, definitely I should do something in this country. So yeah. Best and worst performance. I say one of my best performances, I have a lot of best performances actually. I mean, forgive me if I mention more than one, but top on the list is 2015 at the Lagos Fiesta at Agege. I think that's my first stadium crowd and, you know, it was massive. I believe there were more than, you know, over 2,000 people there that day. As soon as, you know, I started singing Jagaban, like, the crowd pretty much took over. They sang the rest of the song. As far as worst performances go, I would say, you know, before Jagaban, before the whole major fame and everything, there was this show I was performing at, and, you know, I won't even lie, my performance was not even on point. Before I could say anything, you know, the organizers, the stage management and everything, they turned off the lights and somebody came on stage and took the mic from me. And, you know, everything happened so fast. If I knew what was happening, I was already backstage. And, you know, I think that was one of the points in my career where I realized that I actually needed to work really hard at my stagecraft. And, you know, I think after that point, I won't really say I've had any bad performances, but say so, yeah. Wanna kick it in my condo. I tell it show up like pronto. The plans I'm working on for the future, you know, I just released the EP. We have a lot more videos to roll out. Some have been shot already. We're still in the process of shooting some more. So currently I have singles that I've recorded, post EP releases and everything. I'm working on my album, working on a major tour in Nigeria, outside Nigeria, in the UK and the US and everything. Bubbly. You know we bubbly, killing the game, no apology. Well, you have been watching your boy YC on brand new season of My Music and I. Keep watching Sound City, don't go anywhere, don't touch that dial, keep it locked. Too much you, 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 too much you.